这三级的用地你要把这刚给送了一点呢我们就是这两个泡沫出来的了又不敢吃等你你送我扩汤去那里我不要轮椅了等你把我走到你走到你我家也没了等你我不来扩汤去赶紧他的就有了一个你等你我把个牛肉无论几里吧，两场面恐怕也就解决了的。可他这人就可能把你也去解散了的。恁中国人几里吧，嘿，罗马在那多久旁边只把五十，他都把五十牛肉了的。这个是个这个，干巴拉的烂命。你旁边这个超级火炉是不光光光不要的，你讲这垃圾些都破坏，忙不要的。对，这男的呢，他打那个感觉的，去做那个以后的，多半你说嘛说，多半你说嘛，这个三级中间这个第八区那个用地，嗯，差差的，你那个送的，对，就给送过来送的，土巴的，就给送过来破了完了，嗯，对，你说真打打的，多半的他打，我从车嘛，从同居的这边以后的。一个你看，你看，他们也必须啥去打，吃东西要买的，吃的要买的，衣食等，让他们怎么办？都把你比如说我，有人的王人吧，王人怕白人吧，你捆绑他女人要吧，没有几百人吧，这他们多弄个存包的等，这几百。忙不了的，原谅。他们他今年都是把这一天送我嘛，都吃的没人了。你我从起码的东巴吃吃这个，也吃点吧。你一说人就跟我吃来钱，我讲你，你让我弄一点吧，起码起码一把单，跟你跟送我解决，他的也吃点嘛，他们吃的我吃，吃有的。
And then on the next page it says in the invitation, the victorious Lord Gyopa possessing the ten powers. And so also that is very meaningful. It is said that Lord Jigten Sungyuan is the royal successor, the emanation of the Buddha Shakyamuni himself. And many prophecies have foretold that in the sutras and in the tantras, Lord Jigten Sungyuan being the royal representative of the Buddha Shakyamuni himself. And generally the Buddha possesses these 10 powers or 10 qualities, which I don't remember in great detail, but they are qualities of the Buddha himself. And to explain the story how Lord Jigten Sungyuan was accepted then eventually as the royal successor of the Buddha, at the time of Pamudrobam, Lord Jigten Sungyuan was in the assembly of disciples of Pamudrobam, and there was a poor begging person who had not even clothes to change and was kind of on the periphery of the assembly. It was a Drupa Khagi Master Lingirepa, and everyone a little bit looked down on him and thought he's a mad person and really belittled him. And during that time, there also was an emanation of Vajravarahi, a Dakini who passed away. And Lingirepa then went to take her skull, the Kapala, her skull, and came with the skull, skull cup, to a feast offering, a tzok offering that was held by Pamudrobam, a great feast offering where many of Pamudrobam's great master disciples attended. And during that time, Lingirepa sang the song which is well renowned in the Jigung Kagyu, the 20 verses of praise to Lord Jigten Sungyuan, wherein he explains the qualities of the Buddha's 12 enlightened deeds, which also was to show the qualities of Lord Jigten Sungyuan and him being the representative of the Buddha himself. And so thereafter, after singing this song, he offered the Kapala to Lord Jigten Sungyuan as a sign that it was meant for him and he was the representative of the Buddha. But at that time, because many people looked down on this master, not many people accepted, but then later on it was established through many many prophecies and scriptural authority where the place of Trikong was mentioned, and also he was the supreme among the assembly. Also he gathered an assembly of disciples of 1,200,000 disciples, and also he was given the name Ratnasri. And although there have been many with the name Ratnasri, there was no one that had a large assembly of 1,200,000 like Lord Chittan Sungan. Therefore, he was established to be the actual representative of the Buddha Shakyamuni himself. And then later on, when Lord Chittan Sungan's enlightened activities were really flourishing and spreading, at that time, everyone then began to accept the words said by Lingi Rinpa that Lord Chittan Sungan really is the royal successor or representative of the Buddha Shakyamuni.
接下来讲的是迎请智慧尊迎请佛王父祖那么在这边我们知道在我们传承里面我们都知道吉天松公主师是释迦牟尼佛世尊的一的心子那么他是代表这个释迦牟尼佛的但是这个吉天松公是释迦牟尼佛的代表这个也有一段历史上的典故我们知道这佛陀是具足十力的十种伟大的力量但是具体哪十种力量我不是记得很清楚那这个故事有解释说吉天松公是在什么样的情况下才渐渐被了解到被接受说他就是释迦牟尼佛的心子他的代表呢在过去是智者帕摩竺巴祖师他有许许多多的大弟子其中有一个是竺巴嘎举的一个大师林吉日巴那他算是帕摩竺巴祖师这些僧团这么重大的僧团里面的一个外围分子那因为他常常可能是不修边幅啊大家有的时候甚至把他看成有点像疯子可是那个时候有一个空行母他其实是金刚亥母的化身那他往生之后呢林吉日巴就用他的头骨做成了一个嘎巴拉一个炉器那么他在某个法会上呢就把这个炉器供养给这个吉天松公主是而且在这个时候呢唱出一个在我们直贡噶举里面非常有名赞颂吉天松公的二十句的偈子那么这主要的内容是讲说吉天松公主是如何具足释迦牟尼佛的十二种证悟者的十二种特性等等而最后把这个炉器这个空行母的炉器献给吉天松公祖师那因为一开始这么多人都瞧不起这个大师林吉日巴这个大师呢所以也没有说太注意可是后来慢慢的也有不同的议员提到就说子贡噶举怎么样在子贡这个地方会有怎样的传承还有说这个祖师会聚集多少弟子呢？大。